就跟我老一样。
Yes. I'll give you the 8-yard question first, and then you can do the
bird. Yeah.
So ADR is basically it's like when you're replacing. It was automatic.
Automatic dialogue replacement.
Yeah. Basically, it's just anytime you're in the booth, you have to replace any dialogue or anything in the helmet heads that were supposed to there.
That makes someone here knows where buttery comes. So why don't you guys answer it? Yeah, but he but maybe some other people don't know. Do you want to tell us?
Well, there's a thing that his character does. Maybe you should explain that, but maybe not everybody has seen that. But his character does this buttery thing.
That you guys seem to really, really dig. it was just me going out for Indian food one night, and Bruce Kalish asked me how the food was, and I had buttered chicken, which I adore, and I said it was buttery. Next episode, there's a scene, and there's a when you get a script, you get when they do revisions to it, you get little asterisks for when there's the script has been rewritten. And there's a page of it that was all rewritten, all about Bridge eating toast and how buttery it was, and like it's had me do buttery like 3 times. You guys freaked out over it, so thanks.
Cool.
We had Dala coach us at all times. A wonderful guy, coach in the party, who very generous, very helpful. He's actually Canadian, and I think his Canadianness allowed him to also pick up on because he studied American accent. You know, he's very good at Canadian accent. He's worked in Australia and he's made too much money. He's able to pick up on those. It's fantastic. But you know, in Australia, we grow up with so much American television, American culture, and so. The standard guy walking on the street in Australia, our age, will be able to come up with a full American accent. It's just natural. People crack jokes in American accents all the time. You know, there's something heightened about the American accent, which allows you to do wonderful drama and wonderful comedy out of it. And so a lot of the writing in Power Rangers probably wouldn't work if it wasn't an American accent, in my opinion.
Well, when we received the scripts, I always used to read them so I knew what the line was and practice it before we actually went on set. That's how I actually got used to saying the lines in American properly. Well, I try my best, you know. But yeah, that's basically how I did it. I'm sure a lot of the cast members did that as well. But like Gareth said, during, I think, for the first half of the season, we had a dialogue coach, Jim McCarty, who was there to help us and make suggestions on how we could do it better or how to make it easier for us. And yeah, it was really good work. But for the second half of the season, he left. So it was basically down to us. But I'm sure we did a pretty good job. It made us discipline ourselves, so we knew what we was doing. Yeah, that's it.
I should have told you about my beans because you gotta look out for it every time I like it.
I already did it
about,
I think it rocks.
Disney, I use an Aussie accent, and it's
volunteer for me. I don't have to, like, these guys, I don't have to read my lines before I said them. I can just read them while I said them. So it was fun. It was good. And I could also bring other things to the script and say, no, I wouldn't say that because I'm a Aussie. And I could change the words and change how I phrase things. So I really didn't have to learn the words. I just kind of went with my instincts at Sandy.
Didn't you have a limit as to how many meats you could say in an episode?
Mate. Is that the word you're saying?
Yeah.
So, he's gonna give you his Aussie accent. Yeah, man, come on. Matt's got the best Aussie accent I've heard any Canadian do.
It's an undeniable truth. I am awful at accents.
Give me a shot.
No, we're not talking. Tell me something to say.
Well, take
a day. In Aimate.
He's nervous, he needs water now.
Yeah, I did have limits on that.
Now I'm going to do it while I'm drinking water.